Staying on politics, Corey Lewandowski says he will not run for the U.S. Senate in New Hampshire next year. President Trump's former campaign manager announced the decision in a series of tweets Tuesday morning. In the tweets, Lewandowski says, quote, "After much consideration, I have decided to forego a campaign for the U.S. Senate." He also said he wanted to focus on making sure President Trump gets reelected. Lewandowski's decision now leaves it up to several other Republicans to take on Democratic Senator Jeanne Shaheen in the September primary. Senator Shaheen is seeking a third term in 2020. So let's bring in Michael Graham. He's a CBSN political contributor, conservative columnist, and political editor at Inside Sources. Michael, thanks for being with us. We read the tweets, but what ultimately led to Lewandowski's decision to not run for the Senate?
Well, there's a lot of speculation in New Hampshire that it had to do with the fiscal success he's had since Donald Trump went to the White House, being part of what he calls the swamp. And so he's doing pretty well in the swamp world. So that's part of it. Another consideration is probably that Jeanne Shaheen is very popular. You know, she makes the list of the top 10 most at-risk seats for 2020, but that's just because there are so few seats that are truly competitive. She's at best a likely Democrat pickup, if not a solid or a solid Democrat hold in New Hampshire. But here's what's interesting is Corey Lewandowski was having an outsized impact on the fight to hold the Senate in 2020 for Republicans and Democrats. Democrats need to pick up 4 seats, assuming that they don't get the White House. And where are you going to go to get those seats? You're going to go to places like Colorado, where Cory Gardner is an incumbent Republican who's struggling. Senator McSally in Arizona was appointed to the seat, hasn't been elected. Her seat's going to be tough. And then, of course, Susan Collins in Maine is a likely target. Corey Lewandowski's presence in the race was causing Democratic donors to flood Jeanne Shaheen with money because they wanted a chance to get Trump. And as Corey Lewandowski is Trump's former advisor, he's well associated with him, it was really driving grassroots money to Senator Shaheen. Meanwhile, Democrats are going, hey, there are these other races that are a lot more competitive. Let's get some money into Colorado. Let's get some money down to Alabama, where a Democrat holds a Senate seat there, Doug Jones. That's going to be very difficult in a red state like Alabama to hold on to. Now that Lewandowski's out, his name won't be part of the national fundraising, and I think that that will be viewed as good news by Democrats who don't want to admit that, you know, on TV, but they'll be saying, phew, glad that's gone.
Well, you mentioned good news then. So how are Democrats reacting to this decision, though? You sort of hinted at that. What does this mean for their 2020 strategy?
Right. So the Democratic Party in New Hampshire, of course, gleeful and gloating. Corey Lewandowski, being who he is, he put in his message, if I had run, I would win, and because that's the kind of guy he is. So, you know, there's Corey. And so they were reacting to that. But I do know that people around Shaheen saw Lewandowski as the most dangerous candidate in the field. And it has to do with the kind of the theory about what 2020 is going to be like for Senate candidates, congressional candidates, governor, you know, Trump and whoever the Democrats nominee are, they're going to do what they're going to do. But if Trump can do in 2020 what Barack Obama did for his reelection in 2012, they could change the race. And what Obama did is Obama was actually losing among the universe of people who usually vote. So President Trump and his team went out and found new voters, people who don't vote as often, younger voters, minority voters. And they got those voters energized enough to come out to the polls, those reluctant or rare voters. Team Trump is looking at a similar strategy in places like New Hampshire and Colorado and New Mexico, et cetera. And that is finding rural white working class voters who rarely vote. They're not, they're maybe no college, maybe even their high school dropouts. And they think, ah, they're all a bunch of crooks. If they can energize those people who seem to like Trump to turn out, that can change a lot of races. Corey Lewandowski was viewed as the kind of candidate who might help that happen, and that was making Democrats nervous in New Hampshire. The question is, can that strategy work? And the political consultants I talked to all say the same thing. In 2020, either Trump is going to pull out a wave of these rare voters, and it's going to topple people like Senator Shaheen, and it's going to protect people like Cory Gardner and Susan Collins, or it's going to be 2018 all over again. People hate Trump. They're going to swarm in, and Republicans are just going to take it on the chin across the country.
So we're now weeks away from the first in the nation primary in New Hampshire. What are you specifically watching for?
I'm watching for Senator Elizabeth Warren because, first of all, she's from next door. Second of all, she was polling very well here just a few months ago. People forget, but a year and a half before the election, she was declared front runner on the front of New York Magazine. Since then, she's had some tough times, you know, up and down. She pulls. People say that she and Bernie Sanders are competing with the same voters, but that doesn't seem to be the case. She's actually competing with Sanders for some progressives, but also with Mayor Pete Buttigieg. They're both part of what people call the wine track voters, you know, the college educated, suburban, affluent voters. And because she's pulling from both of them, if she does well, if she can get her mojo back and start getting back up into the 20-25% New Hampshire, that hurts both of them. If, however, she continues to decline and she's down in the low teens and going in the wrong direction, that frees up voters. And if Pete Buttigieg can pull an Iowa surprise and then pull a New Hampshire surprise, that completely changes 2020 going forward. If you have the more traditional Biden does okay in Iowa, you know, Warren does okay in New Hampshire, blah, blah, then that keeps things muddy going into Super Tuesday.
All right. Michael Graham, thank you.
Thank you.